Well, hi guys, and welcome back to the channel. Well, this is another episode of my YouTube this week, and I go over what I thought was interesting, you know, over the last little while on YouTube and the channels that I follow, subscribe, and just love to watch. I'm going to introduce you to a guy first, though, because I've been watching this guy for a while, and he's been making so many good vids, you know, and I thought, you know what, I'll introduce you to him now rather than doing a review in the future because, you know, this guy is really good. He deserves a lot of recognition for the hard work that he does. You know, it's not easy making these vids. And now this fella, he has a channel name now, but he's changing his channel name in the new year. And I thought, you know what, I'd wait till the new year, until he changes his channel name. You know, but you know what, I can announce that on my channel when he changes his channel name. Because this guy is that good. He's top notch, he's a quality guy. A lot of you guys probably know this fella, but you know, a lot of you guys don't know this fella. And that's why I'm here. But this guy's name is Ivan. Really nice fella. Knows his stuff. Professional tech, professional, knows his stuff, and you know what, it's a pleasure to even mention a guy like this on my channel, you know, with the rest of the people that I mentioned on my channel as well. And Ivan, he's at MotoYam82, and I'm going to leave a link down the bottom for Ivan's channel, and I recommend anybody who's interested in automotive diagnostics, you know, and this guy really knows his stuff. I'm talking about, you know, like we're getting physics, we're getting trigonometry, we're getting all kinds of fancy stuff in here all at the same time. And, you know, making these kind of vids is not easy. You know, this guy, most of his vids are done in the field. And, you know, they're hard to do. And, you know, especially, you know, videotaping and, you know, it's not easy. But, I mean, Ivan did a vid, I think it was last week. Okay, we're going with last week. He did a vid with Eric O, and he was over at Eric's place. And they were diagnosing this Ford truck that had a problem. And they worked on this Ford truck for the longest time, and they couldn't find anything wrong with it. And I think that's because there was nothing wrong with the truck. But I'll tell you what, you know how hard it is to find a problem that's not there? It's even harder to find a problem, you know, when it's not there than when you actually have a problem. So, you know, that was an interesting vid, you know, and it kind of reminded me of, you know, reviewing channels that don't have vids. I mean, if these guys can diagnose a truck that good to prove there's nothing wrong with it, well, there you go. There you go. Okay, so I'm going with that. And, but later on in that vid, he diagnosed this Honda Civic No Start. And this is a common thing on the Hondas. And for a lot of you guys that, you know, have Hondas, and, you know, if you're interested, you know what, I'm going to put a link for Ivan's channel for that vid, you know, where he collaborates with Eric O from the South Main Auto channel. And, you know, I thought that was a pretty good vid. You know, it's not often that, you know, somebody comes in and says, take a look at my truck, there's something wrong with it, and you can't find nothing wrong with it. Well, that's a tough one. So, okay, so now what are we going to move on to now? Okay, what's next? My buddy Thomas. He did this vid last week. Just blew my mind. And, you know, I think I'm pretty sharp. Well, sometimes. And, well, he did this vid on diagnosing a temperature sensor on this, I think it was a VW. Okay, we're going with VW. It's a VW. He did this temperature sensor diagnostic, you know, and how to figure out about the temperature sensor and how to diagnose it properly. And man, he does a good job at doing this kind of stuff. And at the end of the vid there, he cleaned out the, you know, the terminals. The terminal had corrosion on them. And I couldn't believe what this guy uses to clean out the terminals. You know, they get all them, what does Eric say, them green crusties or something like that. You know, how do you clean that? I've never seen this done before. And I'm going to put a link in the vid down the bottom here for Thomas's vid. I think that's a fantastic vid. You know, you're going to learn how to diagnose a temperature switch. And who do we have next now? We got, Terry. Oh, yeah, Terry. Stesman 52. Man, I'm going to put a link down the bottom for this one, too. Because this guy, it's a part two series. There's going to be a part three. But this is the part two, and this is the ultimate explanation of how a fuel tank level sender potentiometer works. And the vid's, I think, around a half an hour long. And I'm telling you, there's no rocks unturned here. I mean, this guy, he's digging real deep. And you know what? Unbelievable vid on the whole explanation of how the whole system works. And I think on the last vid is going to be the install. But I'll put a link down the bottom for that. That is a worthy vid to take a look at. I recommend everybody take a look at that vid. And what else happened last week? Let me take a look here. Oh, my buddy Terry, WTBM123. He did this vid on, he's got this Silverado. Good man, Silverado. And he did this vid on, he had like a low brake pedal, kind of spongy kind of a thing. And you know, that's a hard diagnosis to do. And so he figured it out, and I looked, you know, and I couldn't see anything wrong, but he figured it out that it was the brake hoses, you know, the four flex hoses on each corner. And I thought, that's a fantastic vid. You know, like, how many guys would know where to look for something like that? And I'll put a vid. I'll put a link in the bottom there for Terry's vid. WTBM123, and you take a look and see what he used instead of them rubber brake hoses, because I thought that was pretty sharp. And I mean, you know, a professional mechanic knows what to use with professional parts. So you guys can take a look at that, you know, and I thought that's pretty good. And we've got Jim the Car Guy. Jim the Car Guy did this vid that I haven't seen nowhere on YouTube. Fantastic vid. I never knew it even existed. You got the tire pressure monitoring system. And there is a common fault. These are all aluminum sleeved. And there's a common fault where the valve core itself will leak. And most times, you're going to take this to a garage, and they're going to want to replace the whole tire pressure monitoring system, like the whole valve, you know, system inside the tire. Well, that could be quite expensive. Now, he shows you how to, instead of replacing everything, for a low-cost option of taking it to your garage, and what they do is, he shows this kit on how to recore the valve stem core. And not have to take the tire off, rebalance it, you know, all that expensive labor time involved. And this is a worthy vid to look at, because I never knew these tools even existed. I never knew they even done that. So, you know, I'm going to put a link down the bottom for Jim and another fantastic channel. What else was going on last week? The other day was Paul Short. Oh my God, this Paul Short. He did this fret press. Now, I didn't know what a fret was. You know, for somebody who's not musically inclined, I had no idea what a fret was. I'm not too sure if he was making wine. I didn't know what he was doing with, you know, he's going to make a fret press. But he made this fret press. And a fret is, well, I don't know what a fret is, really. It has something to do with a guitar. And it's, you know what? It seems to me it holds the strings on a guitar, maybe. No, that wouldn't be the strings. I think they got these little doohickeys at the end there to tighten them up. Well, I think these keep the strings flat. Well, I'm not too sure if they do that either. Well, if you guys know what a fret press is, you're going to love this. Because this here is for pressing in these frets. And you know what? I'm still not clear what these fret presses are. But anyways, he took an arbor press. I think it's a one-ton arbor press. And he built this thing around it. Unbelievable about this fret press. And at the end, Kathy made this decal. I don't know how she makes these decals, because these decals are just right off the, you know, like, I don't know how you make this kind of stuff. You can't even buy these decals. Unbelievable. But I'm going to put a link in the bottom for Paul's fret press. And I had a viewer message me about his channel. And he said he was inspired by Paul to start making YouTube vids. And his name is Tasha McMillan. And Tasha, I just took a quick look at your vids there, and you're a Kubota guy. I'm a Kubota guy, you know, and Paul's a Kubota guy. I'm going to put a link in down here for anybody who'd like to watch, you know, Tasha McMillan's vids. He's a, looks like he's a some kind of a store owner in Cornwall, Ontario. And looks like he did a couple of modifications to his Kubota tractor. And I'll put a link down the bottom there for anybody who'd like to go take a look at Tasha. And Tasha, thank you very much for sending that along. And, you know, I appreciate somebody who wants to, you know, to have exposure to, you know, their channel. I mean, I don't mind that at all. I mean, nobody else is going to do that. So, I mean, you know, I figure, you know what? Why not? You know, and, you know, and he was inspired by Paul to make vids. And I thought that was pretty good. And you know what? Paul never did inspire me to make vids. Because you know what? I'm scared stiff of everything that Paul makes. Because, you know, for me, you know, when I was thinking about going into vid making, the last guy to inspire you to make vids would be Paul. Because for me, what he does is so good that how am I going to make vids like that? And I mean, you know, you got to be pretty sharp. You got to have equipment. You know, I mean, and making vids is 10 times. I think the vids probably are just as hard to make as what he's making, because I think Paul's got every type of equipment going for making vids. Like, he's got these doohickeys you put on here, a microphone. So he's got all kinds of stuff. And, you know, like, I don't have that all kinds of stuff. And, you know, my inspiration for making vids was my daughter. She says to me, "Why don't you make some YouTube vids?" And I says, "What are you, nuts?" I says, you know, like, what do I know about making stuff? I mean, what is people going to watch that they want to see me make? I mean, I don't know, like this, you know, what I do, sometimes people might not find interesting. But I figured, you know what, I find YouTube interesting, and I thought I'd give that a try. And the two guys that really inspired me, you know, to coach me along on making YouTube vids was Studsman 52 Terry, top-notch guy, and Eric O. And, you know, Eric O, you know, there's a real nice guy, and same as Terry. I mean, you know, people on YouTube are so nice. Well, not all of them. I mean, come on, I've run across a couple of guys that are like, whoa, I don't know about that. You know, generally, I haven't run across too many people on YouTube that are nuts. A couple of them, yeah, okay. But I mean, you know, everybody's got their thing, and you know, I'm not here to judge people. But, you know, and you know, you wonder why people are making YouTube. I'm not here to get rich off of making YouTube. I'm just here to promote the channels that I like, I enjoy, and they put a smile on my face. And if I can do the same for you guys, well, then, you know, that's a better day. But there's another fella. Never mind about me. There's another fella there. And I got a big kick out of this guy's channel. And he's called Badgertronics. And this guy's got a good sense of humor. He's got a good sense of humor. And I was looking at one of his vids there last night. And this guy's from Australia. I'm sure he's from Australia. He's not from New Zealand. He's from Australia. We're going with Australia. And he's from, I'm pretty sure, like I look a lot, I'm pretty sure he's from this place called Wellington. He's from the Wellington area. And he's got a channel. And last night I'm looking at his vids there. And he put up a vid about if you'd like a sticker, he'd send you a sticker anywhere in the world for his channel. And I thought, wow, Like, I mean, you know, that's pretty good. I mean, you know, I thought that's a pretty good idea. And I've looked at a lot of his vids. And this fella is, he's a high-tech guy. Like a high-tech techie guy. You know, like, well, I don't know. I'm not a high-tech techie guy, so I don't know what high-tech techie guys do. But he did that for a while. And I read, like, a lot of stuff on his webpage. And he's got, you know, he's got a lot of information on this. And he does Euro vids, like Euro cars. And he does a lot of this kind of stuff. And I found it interesting. And Badgertronics, he seems to me, it looks like he quit this high-techy-techy stuff for a while and went into farming. And I thought, wow, farming in Australia. I mean, we ship a lot of cattle over to Australia, so I don't know what kind of farming he was doing. So I was talking to my wife there last night, and I was saying, like, well, what kind of farming did they do in Australia? I remember watching Thomas, he did a vid there on going to Australia, and I never seen one animal. I never seen one animal, like, I never seen anything there. I mean, it was like flat. It was like going through Saskatchewan. That's what it looked like. But, you know, and then it dawned on me, kangaroos. He was farming kangaroos. And I never even dawned about, like, I think kangaroo is like the biggest farming thing they got going in Australia. And, you know, I was raised on a farm. I know all about farming. And we had Hereford cattle. And, you know, we never milked them for milk. It was only for cream. And, you know, then Holstein. Well, the Holstein was for milk. And, but it dawned on me there, like, how do you farm these kangaroos? And I'm thinking, like, you got to have tall fences, like, at least 15 feet, because these things are like giant jackrabbits. And I'm thinking, okay, now do you milk a kangaroo? Or is it for, like, beef? Or do you, like, are these beef kangaroo? Or are they, you know, milking kangaroo? And I'm thinking, man, oh, man. These things got some legs. If you've ever been kicked by a cow, you'll know that kangaroos got big legs. Now, well, they're not as big as a cow, but I mean, wow, I'm trying to think, you know, like Badgertronics. I mean, you know, hats off to you for, you know, for, I don't know, how do you even attach a milker onto a kangaroo? I mean, wow, that's pretty tough stuff. And trying to get them inside. Like, how do you pin up a whole bunch of kangaroos to get them, you know, into the lorry? You know, and I'm wondering, okay, like when you're shipping kangaroos, I can't imagine how you get these things inside the truck. I mean, they're bouncing all over the place, and I don't know. I mean, I'd love to see some kangaroo farming from Australia, Badgertronics. You know, I'm going to put a link down the bottom there for Badgertronics, and maybe he can dig up some vids on farming kangaroos, because I thought that was pretty good, and you know, hats off to Badgertronics. I mean, man, oh man, that's got to be pretty hard farming in, you know, in the Wellington area there of Australia. So, you know, and, well, I think that's pretty well it for this week. And, you know, guys, I'd like to just say thank you to all my subscribers, you know, for watching my vids every week. And, you know, I really do appreciate it. I don't know, like, I mean, you know, I hope you find some of the stuff I'm doing interesting. And, you know, I'd like to promote more people on YouTube that I think deserve the recognition. Just like, you know, Ivan, you know, like he's new to my channel now. And you can be guaranteed that I'm going to be mentioning Ivan in the future, just like everybody else. When they put out their vids, you know, if they got something that I think you might be interested in, I'll mention it. Because, you know, every week I get more subscribers and they really don't know from one week to the next who everybody I'm watching. But if you guys have a channel that you'd like me to look at, you know, just like Tasha, you know, he sent me a note there, but send me a PM and I'll take a look at that channel. And you know, I think that you know, YouTube is a fantastic place for learning. And next week I've got I don't know, like, this is going to be probably one of my toughest ones that I've ever did. I wouldn't say he's a strictly automotive guy. A lot of my channels are automotive, but you know what? I got other channels that are completely off the wall, not automotive. I got guys, you know, coming up, you know, as soon as I get permission from their channel, you know, to mention them on here, then, you know, it's a go. But you're going to be amazed at some of these guys, and I don't think you're going to know who these people are, and I don't think you're going to know who the next guy is. Thanks for dropping by, and we'll see you next week for another series on who I'm going to introduce next week. Take care, and have a good day.